Dear friends, home and abroad, I greet you. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Depends on your time zone. This moment, I found it very imperative that you must be updated on what is happening in Biafra land and in Nigeria at large, and how the world leaders or world powers are reacting to it. So let's go. I want to inform my beloved Biafrans that it seems to them sometimes that international community or world leaders or other countries does not hear what is going on in Nigeria. They are hearing it. I'm telling you confidently. They are hearing it. Most of the time, I traveled out of the country for cardinal reasons about Biafra issue, which I will not begin to tell you here, but I'm doing my part. I'm doing the best I can to make sure that my beloved people are being secured, protected, and whatever that may happen to them wrongly, that God, by His grace, will remove it. So that makes me, most of the time, I leave the country to other countries that know what they are doing in order for them to help, because one person cannot fight for freedom, all right? Freedom fighting is not for one person. Freedom fighting takes a lot of people, because this is a nation. And when you are talking of nation, you are not talking of one person or two persons. And when you are talking of a nation, you are talking of sincerity, integrity, and many more. Because this is the only thing that can build a home, that can build a nation. Biafra is a home. And this is why, by all means, we are fighting to see how we can get to our home peacefully without further interruption, because we have been interrupted at a time without number. Even some of us have paid the ultimate price in this journey. Some of you, it looks strange or appear strange to you, because I know that some of you have gone to my website. You are looking for my website. You are looking for my biography. You are looking for many things about me. But I'm sorry to disappoint you, because I have to shut down everything, because this is a war we are fighting. And it is a terrible war that you don't know who is who. You can see what our fellow Biafrans are doing to sabotage the struggle for Biafra nation, which is not good. Many Biafrans, many Igbos have decided to work with the Nigeria government to be killing Igbos, to be killing Biafrans. Many commanders have died. Many generals in Igbo land have been killed by the hands of their fellow Igbos or fellow Biafrans, because Nigeria government pays them some money, and they decided to become an agent of darkness, killing their fellow Igbos and Biafrans, agent of death. And this is why, when we are fighting for this Biafra issue, you have to be very, very coordinated. If you know how you can protect yourself, you have to protect yourself first before you protect others. Because if you cannot protect yourself, you cannot protect others. So for this reason, I'm here to inform you that anywhere you go, you must hear about Biafra or Biafrans. The government of that country is hearing about Biafra government in exile on daily basis. every day, the government of every country on earth hears about Biafra nation. So, but what happened is what? They cannot just come out and said that they supported Biafra to go, or to they supported Biafra to be a nation. You have to do what you are supposed to do if you want to be a nation recognized. And this is why most of the time the Prime Minister of Biafra Republic in exile travel from one country to another, especially European countries, and to let them know the problems that Biafrans are going through in Nigeria. And those problems, those attacks, you know, frustrations that Biafrans are going through, then the whole world must be aware why you want to exit from your country. The whole world must be aware why you are forming government inside government, which is contrary or against the international community. But because some of us have not been able to know properly what Biafra nation is standing for, or what Biafra nation stands for, so this is why you are very sluggish and sitting on the fence, looking like a pauper, because the way you reason and think is just an assumption. It's just on a zero level. You know, you don't have anything significant in your heart why Biafra must be a nation, and that is why you kick against Biafra coming as a nation. You sideline it, you know, you make caricature of it. But you should know that the way your life is today is not the way your life is supposed to be. Nigeria have made your life so bad and very terrible that you cannot be able to raise up your head, which you are supposed to be in control. You are supposed to be in charge, but you are under their control. They are using you against your people, and you accepted it. And that is the problem that we have with Igbo Hanezes. We have with Igbo politicians, because they allow the Fulani cabals to be using them to be killing their fellow Igbos and Biafrans. So which, when you look at it, you see that is very ungodly. It's not necessary just because of money. The money belongs to you, but somebody is giving you the money and you are killing your people. How do they make money in Nigeria? It's from Biafra crude oil. Because both where they call it Ijo and what have you, they are made up of Eastern region. It's one people. Go to that place they call Ijo. You see that virtually it's Igbo name, and many of them speaks Igbo. So why should we be treating ourselves this way? As if we don't have thinking, as if we are people living in a different world that is not developed at all. So, my fellow Biafrans, what I'm saying this moment should make sense to you. You should pick point from it. So, as we all in one accord agreed that we shall have Biafra, we begin to make a noise about Biafra, begin to talk about Biafra, wherever you found yourself, in any country. So, make known whom you are and your identity. I want to tell you that till now, some Biafrans have not even registered, you know, that they are Biafrans, that they are registering for, a referendum. They want to have their own country. They have not done that. So, which is not good, because they feel like this Biafra of 13, which day is it going to come? So, but what I'm saying this moment is that powerful nations or world powers have recognized Biafra and what Biafra is all about. The request for Biafra Nation. And I am telling you that it was not turned down. Not at all. It was not turned down. It was accepted. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have built a strong home, a strong foundation that cannot be broken. You see, all the Nigerians, they remain silent, turn blind eyes and pay deaf ear, as if they don't know what is going on. You know their problems? Because all of them invested in Abuja. And Abuja, call it his middle bet. Yes. Or some of them will say it's in the north. But for your information, your investment is not more than your life. This is why Nigerian politicians pay deaf ear and turn blind eyes to anything that have to do with Nigeria disintegration. They will order for you to be killed. Because why? They don't want Nigeria to be disintegrated, because they are making money only for themselves and their family. They don't care about any other person from that amalgamated contraction called Nigeria. So what I'm telling you this moment is that no matter how anybody may feel, no matter how some people are feeling, the quest for Biafra Nation will not be stopped. And we didn't see the reason why we should stop it. Because we are not comfortable. And we don't belong to Nigeria. And that's why they are killing us every day, every moment. And any little thing that happened, they will put it on Igbo's head, the Biafran's head, that the Biafran's caused this, Igbo's caused this. But they overlook Fulanis, who are busy terrorizing everywhere, killing people without conscience. Nobody talks about them. Even this ordinary protest that they are protesting, Hausa people have said that it is Igbos that cause the protest. Just for no reason, you get up and begin to insult somebody who is more than you. And the Yoruba people now issue order that Igbo people should leave Yoruba land and they go back to wherever they are coming from. Just treating you like an illegitimate child. And you accepted it. And this is why you remain silent. Whatever Simon Ekpa and Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and Metu Maribe are doing, it doesn't concern you. As long as you are the Igbo man, as long as you are concerned, there is nothing like Biafra. This is what is ringing on the mind of many people. But it will be too appalling that you just wake up one day only to on your television or your radio, you hear, "Welcome to United States of Biafra." You will be highly disappointed, because all what is going on now, the sufferings and pains and anguish, and the ultimate prices that people from Biafra land are paying now, you exempted yourself. You ran away. You are sitting on the fence. If it is good, then you will come. If it didn't work, then you join the Nigerians. It's very, very unfair. And it is a deceptive life. You are a dangler. You are not up, you are not down. So, and nobody can be in the air. And this is the truth. And some of you are waiting for Nigeria to recover from the pandemic that gripped it. You are waiting for Nigeria to recover. Here, I want to tell you this moment that nothing will make Nigeria to recover. Nigeria is dead and it is completely dead. Nigeria will not be better than the stage it is now. I'm assuring you the truth. Because all the thieves and armed robbers who are in Aso Rock, and all the terrorists who are in the military barracks and police barracks in Nigeria. You cannot change them. You have not removed all of them. And you cannot remove all of them to say that you have overhauled the system of terrorism and evil people in Nigeria. Therefore, I'm here to inform you that come shine, come rain, that Biafra is inevitable, not negotiable. As you listen to me, every hands are on deck to make sure that Biafra come in peace. Because we don't want people dead, and we don't want our people to die again. They have died more than enough. Nigeria have killed Biafrans more than enough. So this is why we want to use wisdom, because Bible said that wisdom is better than the weapon of war. So as we are using wisdom moving, we believe that victory is ours. Those who have property in Abuja and many parts of North and Yoruba land should see how they can arrange their property, or if they wouldn't mind, they like to become a Yoruba man or a Hausa man, we are not against them. They can continue what they are doing. But what I'm telling you this moment is that the truth cannot be overemphasized. The world powers have received the letter addressed to them by the Prime Minister of Biafra Republic in exile. And they welcomed it with gladness. They welcomed it with two hands. They accepted Biafran's request to be on their own, to become a sovereign nation. They are very much interested in the request for Biafra to become a nation. So we are not waiting for anybody, because nobody is willing to join us. We are doing the little we can do to make sure that whatever that will not allow Biafra to come is removed. And because you are far, you don't understand what we are doing. As you don't want to get close, you don't want to be part of us, you don't want to be a Biafran agitator. So I don't think we are supposed to inform you or tell you what we are doing or how we are going. Because Nandeba is not an Okunuku, Mambo Charaku. Since you don't want to be close, there's nothing anybody can do to you. But time shall come when everybody shall give account of what he or she have done. For your information, we are making noise in your ears, and we are ranting, all right, that we cannot do anything. So, but let me tell you that we are not making noise. And if you feel it's noise making, then it's a joyful noise, because Biafra is here. And our noise cannot be overemphasized. And we cannot be tired of making noise everywhere, not only on the social media. We are on ground as well, in every part of Biafra land, to curtail the menace of Boko Haram, ISWAP, Al-Qaeda, ICC, and the rest of them that Buhari introduced to finish indigenous people of Biafra so that Fulanese can settle in Biafra land. My dear, this is not the time of insult. It's the time of action. Because action speaks louder than voice. But we are going by action, we are going by voice at the same time. This tells you how young we are and how full of strength we are. So I will leave you here till I come your way again.